Now, a KCBD News special. This is the Honor Flight, a Veterans Day tribute.
Good evening, I'm Karin McCay. Today is November 11th, Veterans Day, a time to remember those who have sacrificed so much to protect our freedom. Tonight, we honor our area veterans with a special focus on the first South Plains Honor Flight, an all-expense-paid trip to Washington for veterans to see the war memorials built in their honor. You may have made a donation recently to make that trip possible. We hope this program will show you how much that donation is appreciated. You know, more than 80,000 veterans have made this trip from other cities since 2004 when the World War II Memorial was first completed. But surprisingly, there has never been a flight out of Lubbock until 6 weeks ago. And this first South Plains Honor Flight took a lot of hard work and organization from a local committee made up of volunteers. And October 2nd was the big day that so many had looked forward to for so long.
There we go.
It's the morning of a personal mission for R.C. Littlefield and dozens of area World War II vets, all called to Washington, D.C. to see how we appreciate their service to our country.
We've almost waited too long to try to do that for some of us.
I appreciate that. Thank you.
It all started with a one-day telethon to raise the $200,000 needed to send nearly 100 veterans to the nation's capital, many with caregivers to assist them or push wheelchairs.
Thank you for your service, and you have a good time over here.
The South Plains Honor Flight is a result of a community coming together to honor those who lived World War II while they still live among us.
The first responders here in their dress uniforms, it's just overwhelming, really, what you're seeing here. I am just thrilled. I cannot wait to go.
On this first South Plains Honor Flight, Lubbock's mayor paid his own way to ride along as a volunteer and to represent the city. But the stars here are the greatest generation, humble and grateful from the start.
All these people have used their own time to come up here and do these things. And we appreciate you so very, very much.
Thank you folks so much for being out here to help us get off.
And after an impressive pre-dawn send-off, these war veterans, grandfathers, and some great-great-grandfathers had 3.5 hours in flight to reflect on what this trip means. And despite the rain, what a welcome in Washington.
Yeah, here we go. Yes, I did.
With sailors and well-wishers lining the way.
We go to front on the plane. 95.
And while all the people cheered, the memories returned.
Well, we carried about 6 500-pound bombs, and I was the radio gunner when we were in combat.
They had lots of memories. It's hard to get over.
I've seen Boston and New York, New Orleans, but this is a thrill. I love it.
On tap for the next 3 days, 6 memorials, 3 museums, countless attractions, and a tour of the Capitol building.
Hey, we're looking for a great time today.
And even if you've seen D.C. before,
your wheelchair goes on your bus.
It's different, more glorious, seeing it through the eyes of our forefathers and hearing what they remember.
It was the kind of war that we had to fight for democracy, and we sure feel it was worth every bit of it.
There's your salute, right over here to the right.
And to their surprise, our first stop off the bus was the very reason for the trip. When we come back, we begin the tours, and you'll see a different side of our veterans, the camaraderie and the tears they shared as these men honor their fallen heroes. That's coming up when the South Plains Honor Flight continues.
Now, a KCBD News special. This is the Honor Flight, a Veterans Day tribute.
On this first South Plains Honor Flight out of Lubbock, I had the privilege of going along with 2 photographers from News Channel 11. The 3 of us were actually a little disappointed to see that it was raining hard as we flew into Washington. From inside the plane, you could barely make out the water cannon salute on the runway to welcome our flight of veterans. But they noticed and they loved it. Earlier in our program, you saw the great reception they got at the Washington airport. That's when the party started. Remember, this is a flight of mostly 80 and 90-year-old veterans with a common bond, all having lived a part of the history that most of us just study in books. I would overhear them say, You were on Paris Island, I was on Paris Island. It was at first like a joyful reunion until a certain statue changed the mood completely. But let's begin now with our first chance to get off the bus and see Washington. And by the way, that's when it stopped raining. The first stop off the bus in Washington was to see the one memorial that honored almost all the veterans on our trip. To see the World War II Memorial, the newest of them all, completed just 8 years ago when most who served in that war were already in their 80s.
Left, right.
Yet in a personal mission more than 60 years after the war, they marched in formation to lay two wreaths at the site. One for those who fought in the Pacific.
I think we had 125% casualty and lost a lot of good friends.
The other wreath to remember those who fought in the Atlantic. World War II was the deadliest conflict in history. 400,000 Americans lost their lives, remembered by the 4,000 gold stars on this Freedom Wall. The Enola Gay was the plane that dropped the first of two atomic bombs that ended the war. The Superfortress is preserved now at the Smithsonian Air and Space Museum.
The most advanced aircraft that the United States built in the Second World War.
A third of the airplanes on display here are one of a kind, but no one was more impressed than our guide when he discovered who was in his tour group.
You worked on this airplane? I am honored to have you here.
And two others in the group trained on the B-29 bomber. Doc Haney was a co-pilot, and Buster Coomer, a gunner.
It brings chills, really does, to see the aircraft again.
In fact, I'm the only B-29 pilot that I know is still alive.
Well, I guess I'm the only mechanic I know better than I
And the only gunner, right?
I guess so, as far as I know.
It was a celebration of rock stars who had lived the stories written in this museum.
Hey, this is the highlight of my life right now.
But yet another highlight would soon bring tears. The Marine Corps Memorial symbolizes a victory that was the turning point in World War II, the raising of the flag at Iwo Jima. And it was this wreath that brought the most empathy, since many here fought at Iwo Jima or lost friends who did.
Iwo Jima was supposed to be 3 days. It was going to be an easy operation. It took 30 days. The hills were 500 feet high. We couldn't see them, but they could see us.
I was on Iwo Jima from day one. Yes, I was there within a half a mile of that when that went up. Got up and saluted it. And everybody else did too.
The whole Marine Corps holds respect for those boys.
Pete Wheeler wasn't on Iwo Jima, but he was in the Pacific. And the memory of his fellow Marines killed on that island was overwhelming.
You're doing well. Keep going.
We just want everybody to know we'll do it again in a minute.
That is the reason we honor our veterans. We'll be back.
Now, a KCBD News special. This is the Honor Flight, a Veterans Day tribute.
Earlier, I told you three veterans in our group were considered rock stars at the Air Museum. The truth is, our group was full of rock stars. There are a lot of tourists at these memorials in Washington, and our guys, noticeably older and wearing World War II caps, were the stars in every crowd. It was not unusual for a tourist to ask one of our veterans if they could take a picture with them. One veteran told me he got choked up when a young man said, "My grandfather isn't here anymore. I never got to thank him for his service, so I'd like to thank you for yours." Our veterans also enjoyed some quality time together out there. Many have told me that it wasn't just seeing the memorials that brought tears as much as seeing them with their fellow veterans. Now, back to the tour. And the next stop off the bus, Arlington Cemetery. The sounds of war are buried here at our National Cemetery. with more than 300,000 stones quietly guarding the remains of a soldier. But perhaps the best-known memorial to those killed in service is the Tomb of the Unknowns. Since 1921, the changing of the guard has been a ritual every hour of every day, witnessed on this day by our veterans.
Remain silent and stand.
Again, a wreath is presented. Remember Gene Heath, the mechanic who worked on the Enola Gay? He led the procession. Another veteran behind him, Edward Kostelich, was a Pearl Harbor survivor.
I think it was a great honor and a privilege.
And Mayor Glenn Robertson, representing Lubbock.
It was amazing, an experience that I will never forget.
Reset! Oh!
And the fourth from the honor flight was Nikki Gage, also holding the wreath.
I'm probably the youngest one here.
His reason for being here will later become obvious.
There's not anything that can top this other than getting to heaven.
And that's the mission of the South Plains Honor Flight, to give the greatest generation the greatest experience in the home stretch of life.
Thank you very much.
And who better to thank them for their service than our congressman? So we made the picture postcard walk to the Capitol for a tour of the House chambers and a personal meeting with Lubbock Congressman Randy Neugebauer, who gave each veteran a coin and a captured memory.
Present! Oh!
But a much longer hike came later that day, starting with a somber march to the Korean War Memorial. 19 statues in windblown ponchos depict the trek through Korea's rugged terrain.
I flew 90 combat missions and damaged one MiG-15 in aerial combat. One of the reasons that I made this particular trip was to see what it was like, and it's impressive.
But for some, the most heart-wrenching was yet to come. Beyond the Lincoln Memorial and down the hill, Dominique Tartaglione finally sat. His caretaker explained.
He's been in a wheelchair most of the tour, but he insisted on walking down here to honor his comrades.
The 91-year-old was a soldier in World War II and 30 years later volunteered to serve in Vietnam. Remember Nikki Gage, also a Vietnam veteran? He and Dominique stood side by side and walked in honor of the 58,000 names of the dead or missing etched in the wall beside them.
I counted 54 names on this wall that I'd personally witnessed give their lives for this country. And out of that 54, seven of those men died in my arms.
The Vietnam Veterans Memorial is a sacred place to find the name of a missing loved one and plant a flag in honor of their service. Fred Harvey found the name of one of his students who became a helicopter pilot.
Daniel Wayne Thomas. He was shot down, and this means that he's missing in action. They never were able to recover the remains.
In all, 58,000 reasons for this Vietnam veteran to get up from his wheelchair and walk.
I'd crawl if I had to. Yes. It's worth it to me. My heart's in it.
When we come back, a look at the volunteers who made this trip successful and the relationships that became stronger in 3 days.
Now, a KCBD News special. This is the Honor Flight, a Veterans Day tribute.
There were 137 people on the South Plains Honor Flight. Nearly 90 of those were veterans. Sadly, there were many more who wanted to go, but there were only so many seats on the plane. So what about all those other people? There would be no honor flight without them. All the volunteers, including the mayor, paid their own way to help. Some veterans could not have gone without the help of a family member who came as a volunteer. And what an eye-opener it was for those who went to help. Many volunteers told me that even among family members, these veterans told stories in Washington they had never heard before. So even if it started as a trip among family or friends, the bond grew stronger for all who were a part of the South Plains Honor Flight.
I think it's wonderful that we have so many from Plainview here that can share this together.
We started this trip together, the three of us.
childhood friends J.W. Hamby, James Crossland, and S.M. True drove from Plainview to Lubbock with the same dream, getting a spot on the first South Plains Honor Flight. As word spread, the list grew to include six World War II veterans from Plainview.
Yeah, here we go.
Yes, I did. Welcome.
At 92, Doug Douglas was full of energy from the start, grateful to be here like all the others.
Very thankful for all the people that made this flight possible for us.
But one of the three who made that first drive to Lubbock didn't make it to Washington.
Dad died May the 15th.
S.M. True died suddenly in a farm accident, so his buddies made sure his picture went with them to every memorial.
Well, my dad was a night fighter in World War II. Oh, I'd give anything if he were here.
It was in his dad's honor that David became a volunteer.
That's for you.
Just like about 40 other family members or friends who paid their own way from Lubbock or other locations to join the tour and escort a veteran to make sure their journey was a safe one.
This is a blessing to be here with my dad.
I'm 91 years old.
He is the epitome of the greatest generation.
Like all the others, we honor for their service and the suffering that came with World War II, something many have not spoken of until gathering here at these memorials.
There was such suffering and death, statues like that, and being with these men over here make you feel good about all that's happened.
And this is kind of a closure for them to kind of cement that memory in their minds.
A lot of memories.
It was bittersweet when Doug and the rest of the Plainview bunch gathered at the Iwo Jima Memorial to send a picture back for the Plainview Daily Herald.
I've known all these men all my life. Yeah. Praise God, we got them. Yeah.
But as the years go by and World War II becomes more distant, it's estimated that as many as 1,000 of those veterans are dying every day, and with them, a story is lost.
I had a tank blowed up with a mine in a minefield.
Charles fought in the Atlantic while his brother Ernest was in the Pacific. So what does a trip like this mean 67 years later?
Kind of brings back some memories that you'd kind of forgotten. Maybe you wanted to forget, I don't know. But it's worth the trip, a wonderful trip.
The last picture of the entire group was beside the Lincoln Memorial, and front and center was Doug Douglas.
Yeah, here we go.
Yes, I did. Welcome.
48 hours after returning home to a cheering crowd, Doug Douglas died in his sleep. And his family says in those last 2 days, all he could talk about was the trip of a lifetime. Some final thoughts when we come back.
Now, a KCBD News special. This is the Honor Flight, a Veterans Day tribute.
After returning from the South Plains Honor Flight, 86-year-old Gail Hudson, a World War II veteran, hand wrote a 6-page letter to his daughter. He described the trip in every detail and what it meant to him to be a part of it. We later found Gail Hudson, and you'll hear from him in a moment. But first, it's estimated there are about 3,000 World War II veterans living here on the South Plains. Many have never been to Washington and would not have the opportunity to do so, especially now in their twilight years. So it is a race against time to get them to Washington to see these memorials while they're still in good health to fly and can enjoy the experience. The South Plains Honor Flight Committee is already planning a second flight and hoping many more will continue after that. And if you'd like to make a donation, go to southplainshonorflight.org or call this number 790-4635. We want to thank our veterans for allowing us to go along and tell the story of this honor flight. Caleb Holder and Sarah Blake Morgan were the photographers, and Jason Cannon is the editor who brought this project to life. Our thanks to Digital Base Productions for offering to make a DVD of this entire program free to all the veterans on this trip. Other copies will be provided in return for a donation to the South Plains Honor Flight. On this Veterans Day, we recognize all those who are serving our country now and making sacrifices for our freedom. And we hope that every veteran will someday have the chance to go to Washington to see the memorials built in their honor. We close with some final thoughts now on this first trip, mostly from the veterans who expressed their thanks in Washington, but also from Gail Hudson, the World War II veteran who put his thoughts on paper. Good night, and thank you for supporting the South Plains Honor Flight.
You see the picture, you think, boy, that is great, but it doesn't mean near as much as seeing it in person.
I never expected anything like it. It's beautiful.
I can't describe it. It's great. Wonderful.
It's just awesome. It's just something you'll never forget.
I've been teared up every day here.
And all the people that have made this trip possible, it's just unreal.
A sincere thank you to one and all who are responsible. If we get a little teary, thinking about it all, you made it happen, and it will never be forgotten.